Alright, so good morning. Today I want to talk about zero. We're getting back to the, I've read that, oh, they discovered zero. They're the ones who started zero. That zero was the first, you know, input into the, how should we say it, their scheduling routine and their timing, you know, added to their day that they needed zero. Now, this has nothing to do with our size or our weight. Are you a size zero? But we're talking about impatience. I'm going back to the invent of it. The reason why zero was invented. Okay. So now, if you can do this in a little game yourself. Okay. So let's say you've completed three or four tasks, or you're in the middle of completing maybe five or six tasks. Okay, and so you're there and you're like writing. Let's say you're just writing. So you make a little square or you make a circle and you go, I did that, I completed it. You can go to the next one and say, I've completed the next one. Okay, and you go, oh, and I've completed that. And then, and so what it is, it's like, it's impatience. Do you understand? So you're already filling in the square. You're already filling in the circle. So what happened is like, no, you didn't do that. You did not do that yet. So you can't write it all the way. So somewhere truth is involved. So somebody said, no, you cannot. That square, where is it? Yeah, that square, you cannot actually take that square, like I see I wrote on this paper lots of squares. You cannot take that square and wholeheartedly fill it in. That would be wrong. You didn't finish that task. Do you understand? So it's like, that's where zero came from. Was the empty, I'm gonna do this, I'm doing this, I'm doing this, I'm doing this, and then I start to fill it in, and I'm like, no, I can't fill it in, I didn't finish that yet. To understand, it's just that simple. I didn't finish that yet. So I have to leave it empty. It's nothing to do with the planet, and there's the moon. I have to leave it empty. It's just an empty basket, an empty vessel. It's not done. Okay? So that's where zero came from. Because, yeah, an impatience. I just wanted to fill them all in. I did this, I did this, I did this, I did this. Especially on this computer system. But you can't. You're left halfway done, halfway filled in. You know, I'm trying to convert these e-publications into Kindle and make them look decent. And no, not for picture books. They really went against the picture book people. So no, I'm not making a monstrosity here, but then I am making a monstrosity. I made a doubler. I'm trying to get that through, where it's some type of text, and then the second half version is going to be just the images, because I believe Kindle itself is a dastardly deed to the printed book version people, because who would want to buy that? That looks hideous. Yeah. So now I'm including like a little pretty picture book version of images. So they just gave me so much extra work. I'm kind of mad at them that they just couldn't use regular PDF and just go glunk, that's it, and make a scroll feature, just a simple scroll feature in a Zoom, and that would be that. But no, they went gahooty and decided to make it something else that you have to highlight, or you have to, what's the other thing? Search, you know, I don't know. If they could have made the PDFs work, It should have solved it, but they didn't make the PDF. And then I'm like, well, I guess they didn't make it work on purpose so they could hire more people. That's really what it comes down to, doesn't it? We have to keep making errors on the machine so we can hire more people. Otherwise, you know, what are the people going to do? You know, if all the software is perfect, what are the people going to do? You know, what are they going to do for a living? So anyway, that's what we do here. This application error mishap. That's what we do every day. We just see another application error, so somebody else has a job. You know, it's just disgusting. It's a disgusting system that just it harasses people that are trying to use it, because it's constantly making mistakes on purpose, so people are hired. All right, so anyway, so that's the reason for zero. That's exactly the truth. Let's make an application that is really only halfway there and only halfway a fix. And, you know, I don't know if it's their fault intentionally, but that's what happens. We just end up with another square that just did not work, that we can't fill in yet. So yeah, and you wonder why people are so angry all the time. Well, so we're facing, we have to give the people the work, we have to give them the jobs, and yet in the other token, how can we keep supplying them jobs? Ooh, they have to make errors. I mean, it's just ridiculous. Anyway, I know I'm just feeling ranty.